Let's create a full-featured web story in the next 5 minutes. Don't believe me? Here we go. In the previous episode, I hopefully got you inspired by showing you a bunch of best-in-class web stories out in the wild today. If you haven't watched that episode, go give it a try now or later to get a good sense of what's possible. I could throw a ton of theory at you at this point, but if you're like me, you want to start diving in right away and learn something practical first. And that's exactly what we'll do now. Since this is the internet, we'll go extra meta and create a web story about creating a web story? Yes, we'll turn this very video into a web story. And if you didn't notice yet, this isn't a one-off. Every episode in this series will have an accompanying web story, so that it's up to you how you consume this educational content. You can find every story in the description. But enough talk, let's do this. There are tons of different ways to create web stories, and we'll do a deep dive in a future episode, but today I'll be using a visual editor to create my story. The big advantage here is that there's no need to write any code, and most of these editors sit somewhere between a simple creation tool like Instagram and a full-blown design tool like Photoshop. Today I'll use web stories for WordPress, not because it is the best editor, but because it fits the job and is the tool I'm most familiar with as I help create it. Now I want to call out that this editor works especially well for me, as my website already runs on WordPress. But if that's not the case for you, then no big deal. Another great option, for example, is Make Stories or Newsroom AI, which are both standalone editors you can use without a CMS or website. Most editors have the same basic capabilities. An optional button sometimes might be in a different place, but I'm sure you get the hang of it quickly. Okay, I'm logged into my WordPress admin dashboard now, activated the Web Stories plugin and clicked into the Stories section. Now, I could click that big Create button and that would work, but I would have to end up creating a story from a white blank slate with no visual guidance. Especially while you're starting out, it's completely legit to instead start with one of the provided templates. As you can see, they're fairly full-fledged. Since this series is part of Google Web Creators, I'm not going to use one of the built-in templates, and instead we'll use this template story my team and I have created, which matches the look and feel of this channel and the series. Now we're in the editor. Exciting! One thing maybe not super obvious at first is that a web story isn't a single page at a time, like on most social media platforms. Every web story is a self-contained editorial story with a beginning and an end, so this story will naturally have multiple pages. Now, before I fully design and lay out each page, I personally like to write an outline first and really focus on creating a great story arc. This isn't for everyone, like maybe you want to skip this step and dive right into it, but it really works for me. I like to use Google Docs for this, but totally up to you. Okay, I know that I want my story to have an intro and the five following parts. These parts are, spoiler alert, tool prep, drafting the story, sourcing the content, creating the story, and publishing the story. Now comes the hardest part, sourcing the right content. The right imagery or videos are the make or break of a good web story. If you've been blogging on the web before, this is kind of counterintuitive. With a typical blog post or article, you start with the copy and then find some image to visualize a point. With a web story, you start with the image and then write some copy to clarify your point. For this story, I need a combination of images and short screencast videos. Here's where I cheated and spared you the time it took to create and collect them. That's because this can easily be the most time-consuming and also most boring to watch task. You could of course argue that my 5-minute story creation claim was clickbait, but that really depends on whether you have to create content just for the story or not. In many cases, you'll adapt the story from assets that already exist for some other content like a video or an article, so it's hard to estimate an average here. Let's get to the fun part, the actual story creation. Okay, for the cover image, we first have to select a nice thumbnail that we use from the video. There we go, we're gonna drag this right in here. And something that looks like a call to action button to motivate my readers to click into the story. The next page will be a quick video intro, which I've already uploaded into my media library. Oh, and one important thing, you should use a tool to format whatever video you captured vertically so they are already optimized for web stories, as otherwise they consume more bandwidth and load more slowly. I'm structuring the story slightly differently than the video, as we want to skip right into story creation. So on this page we'll mention that we'll use web stories for WordPress today. And a nice image, cool, and then a link to the actual download page of the editor, if somebody wants to follow along from there. Because of how the WordPress plugin works, I'm also adding a quick page on activating the plugin with a screenshot to the story section. Now into the drafting the story section. I'll use a hybrid template that has both a section title and a video placeholder, in which I'll put a clip about templating. We'll put another clip to the next page that talks about scripting, but instead of showing an overlay in the embedded video, we'll just put it out onto the next page, where we'll also continue the clip from the last page with a different crop factor. Sweet. Over to sourcing. I want to visualize that high quality media is critical, so I have prepared this nice little grid of cool images and then add a video clip explaining this. What's cool here is that I can use the 16:9 video without cropping, as this page is perfectly formatted for that. Now for the meaty part, starting with how to create a story cover. Here I won't use a clip of myself speaking from the front, but a clip from a different camera angle. Let's make sure the video looks good. Wait a second. That's just like my Spaceballs instant cassette I got from Mr. Rental. But if this is now, then when is the next pitch? I guess I just have to finish the story later when this video is finished. Okay, let's skip to publishing then. When you feel good about your story, it's time to release it to the world. That's usually as simple as clicking the publish button. Now the story is in the wild and can be linked to and indexed by search engines, just like a regular web page. From here on, almost everything else is optimization. In the course of this show, we'll explore various ways of making money with stories, as well as how to track success. If you have a website already, I'll also show you how to link to and embed stories from there. Time to create your own story. Head to MDev's tools section to explore a list of available visual editors for all sorts of needs. Subscribe to this channel and stay tuned for more episodes that teach you the ins and outs of storytelling on the web. Onwards.